Hi, Mike Austen, General Service Manager with the Gorman-Rupp Company, here today to demonstrate setting the face clearance on the T2A3-B self-priming centrifugal trash pump. Before we get started, let's talk a little bit about safety. Anytime prior to opening up a pump, you always want to make sure that it is both hydraulically and mechanically isolated. With that in mind, we can go ahead and get started, but first let's talk about the tools we'll need to set face clearance. You could possibly need two pry bars to assist in loosening the rotating assembly from the volute, a 9/16 socket and ratchet, a feeler gauge, a small screwdriver to help assist in prying out the shims between the volute and the rotating assembly, and a lathe dog. Now let's get started. The first thing that you want to do with your 9/16 socket and ratchet is loosen the four retaining bolts that secure the rotating assembly inside of the volute casing. Once we loosen the four bolts securing the rotating assembly inside of the volute scroll, remove two of the screws and insert them into the jacking holes in the rotating assembly to assist pulling the rotating assembly back away from the volute. Once we insert the jacking bolts into each side of the rotating assembly, let's begin tightening the jacking bolts to pull the rotating assembly away from the volute. After tightening the two jacking bolts in the rotating assembly, pulling the rotating assembly away from the volute, you can then pick up a screwdriver or like tool to remove the shim sets from behind the two locations where the jacking screws were removed. After removing the shims from their mounted position between the rotating assembly and the volute, retain each set separately as these sets are of equal combined thickness. After removing the shims, remove the jacking bolts from their current locations, inserting them back into a mounting location in the rotating assembly, diagonal from one another. The next step is to tighten the mounting bolts on the rotating assembly, pulling the rotating assembly with the impeller towards the wear plate while rotating the shaft with a lathe dog at the same time. Once we've reached a rubbing and non-locked condition, the impeller to wear plate clearance is zero. To determine the required amount of shims to set the face clearance between the impeller and the wear plate, measure the gap between the rotating assembly and the volute with your feeler gauge and add to that gap the required amount of shims of 10 to 20 thousandths per the operator's manual. Once we've determined the amount of shims required to set the impeller to wear plate face clearance, we can then remove the mounting bolts from the rotating assembly and pry the rotating assembly back away from the volute to give you additional space required to insert each shim set under each mounting location. After installing each shim set, rotate the tabbed portion inward as a safety precaution. At this point, we want to tighten down the rotating assembly inside of the volute and reinstall the lathe dog on the shaft to ensure that the impeller does not contact the wear plate. This concludes our demonstration setting the face clearance on our T2A3-B self-priming centrifugal trash pump.
For more information on pump hydraulics, equipment, or application engineering, watch Gorman-Rupp's YouTube channel and visit us at grpumps.com.